1970 Plymouth Roadrunner, and it looks like a basket case right now, because it is. The plans for this thing right here, big block, 4-speed burnout. And then we're gonna make it kind of like a NASCAR street legal stock car thing. The lower, big wheels, NASCAR wheels, stiff suspension, autocross ready pretty much.
That pretty much means all the old suspension hasn't come out. We're gonna change torsion bars, adjustable strut rod, dampers, sole arms, bushings, everything. So all of this stuff down here, out.
When it comes to the engine bay right here, the plan is to put a 383 or 440 big block in it, because we gotta need some torque to spin them big tires, right?
So of course this thing was born at 340 4-speed, so of course we're gonna put a 4-speed in it again. But even if it wasn't born at 4-speed, I would still put a stick in this whole thing.
But hey, wait a minute. You guys are still missing a part of the whole story. First of all, here are two pictures of where it's sat in California in some weird parking lot. So before I actually moved to a new shop, I tore the whole car down. Fenders, hood, bumper, transmission out, crossbar mark, everything. So basically just slapped them quick together to move it to the new shop. So I'm gonna show you guys this clip real quick, and also how I prepped the engine bay for paint and stuff like that, because we're literally this close to painting the entire engine bay. Let me roll some old footage real quick so you guys can get up to
today. The good thing is, she's damn near rust-free, at least on this side. We only had to knock out like 5 pounds of dirt, but a Californian car, man. Clean up some dust and there's clean metal underneath. It's so great, it's so awesome. Let's move on to the next fender. So, next thing I'm gonna do right now is try to clean up the engine bay a little bit, because there's dust everywhere. I wanna get an idea of how good the paint job of that metallic silver, whatever it is, if we should repaint the engine bay or just keep it, or maybe like touch it up or whatever. So we just got the headers out and we're also ready to take the rest of the exhaust out now, and then after that we're ready to pull out the transmission. So, let's get right to it. So the next step on the Roadrunner here is we got the whole engine bay stripped down, and now we're just gonna use the DA sander to get everything like scratched up, and then we're gonna paint it.